Hi friends, welcome to Azure Content. This is part 9 in Azure Data Factory playlist. In this video, we are going to learn about additional column in copy data activity in Azure Data Factory pipelines. So in Azure Data Factory pipeline, when we are making use of copy activity, we have an option to add an additional column on top of the source dataset that we have while performing the copy from source to sync. So suppose in our source, we have three columns, okay, and we want some additional data on top of these three columns. So suppose in addition to these three columns, I want to get the time at which the pipeline is running. Then I can do that using the additional column option in copy data activity. So in our sync, we will have the total of four columns while the source is only having three columns. So we can do that with the help of additional column option in copy activity. So these are few scenarios where we can make use of additional column option in copy activity. So the first one says when we need to copy from file based source, then we can store the relative file path as an additional column to trace from which file the data comes from. So what it means is, let me show that practically. Let me go to the ADF pipeline and let me start creating a pipeline and let me try to drag and drop this copy data activity in the white canvas. Okay. So here in the source, we need to select the source dataset. So if our source is a file, suppose let me select an existing delimited text file dataset. So let me select a latest one. So if I select this, in additional column, we have an option to provide the file path from where this file is coming. So you can see by default this value is present, that is $file path, and we have other options as well, that is custom and column and add dynamic content. Okay, but the default option is file path. So if I give some column name here, suppose file path of source. Okay, so this is the column name that it will add in the sync, and its value would be the file path pointing to this data set. Okay, so this option is only present in the source, which is a file based source. Okay, how can we check that? Let me drag and drop another copy activity, and this time I will point the source to a SQL table. Let me scroll down, and here in additional column option, you can see there is no option to select file path. So this option is only present when the source is file based data store. It may be a delimited text file, or it may be a JSON file, or it can be a binary file, but it should be related to file data store. Okay. We have already covered the file formats present in ADF in our previous video, so please go through that. Okay, so let me delete this additional copy activity, and for this one, let me create a new dataset that will be pointing to a specific file that we have in ADLS. So let me select file format as CSV. So I have a file called emp.csv. So let me navigate to this path. Okay, so let me select the existing linked service, and in file path, I have this file in demo container. So let me select demo container, and let me select this file emp.csv. And as the first row is header, so let me select this checkbox and let me click on OK. So our source dataset is ready. So currently we have only three columns, that is ID, name and age. So suppose I want to add an additional column and load it into the SQL table. So the additional column will hold the file path pointing to this file. Okay. So let me add the additional column. So it is already there. So let me leave it as it is. So the column name will be file path of source. Okay. And let me add a sync that will be pointing to a SQL table. And this table is not created yet. So let me click on auto create table, and let me give a name to this table as, suppose, employee table. So we are good. Let me go back to the pipeline. So if I debug this pipeline now, it will add an additional column called file path of source, and its value will be the file path pointing to the source dataset present in our ADLS. Okay. So in the sync table, we are expecting four columns. So let me hit on debug. and let's wait for the pipeline to be executed. So meanwhile, let me go to SSMS and let me start writing the query to select star from dbo.employee table that we are just creating in the sync dataset. So let me execute this query right now. So you can see there's no table right now, which is called dbo.employee table. So it will create the table on the fly. So let's wait for the pipeline to be executed. So let me refresh. Yeah, so the pipeline has succeeded. Let me go back and let me execute again. So you can see it has returned 4 columns, and the last column is nothing but the additional column that we added using additional column option in copy activity. So you can see the source is having only 3 columns and the sync is having 4 columns with an additional column containing file path. So let me go to presentation again. So this is what the first point means. Now coming to the second point, it says we can duplicate the specific source column as another column in sync. So to demonstrate this, let me go back to the pipeline, and here we can add another additional column for which we have to select the value from this dropdown, and we can use this. If I hover on this, you can see it says duplicate an existing source column. Okay, so let me click on this column option, and here we need to provide the name to the additional column that we need to create in sync. So let me give the name as duplicate column from source. Okay, and here you can see there is another dropdown, and in this dropdown we have 3 columns, which is nothing but the columns coming from the source dataset. Okay, so these are the 3 columns: ID, age and name. So you can see ID, name and age are the columns present in the source. So we can create an additional set of same column present in the source. So that means we can duplicate the column from the source. So suppose I want to duplicate this name column. Okay, and let me give the name as duplicate name column from source. Okay, so now if I debug this pipeline, we are expecting instead of 4 columns, we will have an additional 5th column that will be nothing but the duplicate column of this name column. Okay, but before running the pipeline, let me drop the table first, because the schema of this table is already created. So it will lead to failure of the pipeline. So let me drop the table first, and then we will recreate the table by using auto create table option. Okay, so let me drop the table and let me debug this pipeline. So let's wait for this execution to be completed. Then we will check what is the content of this table. Yeah, so the pipeline execution is completed. Let me go back and let me hit on execute. So you can see we have in total 5 columns, where the 5th column is nothing but the duplicate of this name column. So you can see the content as well. It is same as the name column. So now let me go back to presentation. So we have covered the second point as well. So now coming to third point, we can add a column with ADF expression to attach ADF system variable like pipeline name or pipeline ID, or store other dynamics values from upstream activity output. So what this means is, let me go back to pipeline. So here in additional column option, let me add a new additional column, and here in the values I will select this option, that is add dynamic content, and here it gives me the option to use any of the system variables present here. That means we can add an additional column that will hold the pipeline name which has performed this copy activity. Similarly, we can add pipeline run ID or pipeline trigger time. Okay, and similarly, we can add any of the functions, such as suppose we can add UTC now. That means when this pipeline ran, it will add the current timestamp as an additional column. Not only that, we can also add previous activities output in this additional column. So if suppose we would have another activity before this copy activity, suppose there was a lookup activity before this copy activity, let me connect the two activities. So here we would get an option to use the output of previous activities here. So you can see we can navigate to activity output, and we can load that in the sync dataset. So let me cancel this. Let me remove this lookup for now. And for our understanding, let me add two things here. One will be pipeline name. Okay, so let me go to dynamic content and let me hit on this pipeline name option. Okay, so you can see it has automatically generated this code which will fetch the pipeline name and it will store it as the additional column. Okay, and similarly, we will add another additional column. Let's say current time. Okay, and for this, let me go to functions and let me go to date functions and select UTC now. Okay, so now let me again drop the table so that we do not land up on the error, and let me debug the pipeline. So let's wait for this pipeline execution. So we are expecting the total of three columns from the source and then 1, 2, 3, 4 additional column, which means we are expecting 7 columns in the sync table. So let's wait for this pipeline to be executed. Yeah, so the pipeline is completed. Let me execute this query. So you can see in total we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 columns, which is as expected. So this run has generated these two columns, that is pipeline name. You can see pipeline 25 is coming as a pipeline name, which is correct. And then current time. Okay, so this is the UTC now value which we are getting. So this is how we can make use of add dynamic content option in additional column. Okay, so now let me go to the presentation again. And we have covered the third point as well. So the last point is, we can add a column with static value to meet our downstream consumption need. Okay. So we have an option in additional column option where we can add a static value. Okay. So if I go in this drop down, so you can see we have something called custom. And here we do not have any drop down or we do not have any add dynamic content option. We can just pass a hard-coded value here. Okay. So suppose I want to add a new column that will be holding the country name of all the employees. And I know that for all the employees, the country is same, that is India. Okay. So I can give a static value from additional column option. Okay. So let me again drop the table and let me run the pipeline so that we can see that this static value is coming or not. So let's wait for this pipeline execution. Yeah, so the pipeline has executed successfully. Let me go back and let me hit on select start from table. So you can see it has added a new column called country and it contains India as the value for all the rows, which is nothing but the static value that we have added in the additional column option. So if you get these kinds of scenarios where on top of source data, you have to add some additional details, then you can make use of this additional column option and it will easily do our job. So not only we can add on top of the source data, we can go to the mapping and we can also remove the data coming from the source that we do not want. Okay, so suppose let me import schema. So it is asking for the dummy data for this value. So suppose let me give pipeline 25 itself and let me hit on OK. So it will import schema for both source and sync. So you can see all the columns that are coming from source and sync are coming in this mapping option. OK, so if I don't want this ID column in the sync, then I can simply delete this. Or if I want the column rearrangement, suppose if I want country column to be coming after age column, then I can simply hold this and keep it in the top. Okay, so if I run this now, it will remove the ID column in the sync and it will rearrange the column as we want. Okay, let me show you that as well. Let me drop the table again and let me hit on this debug option and let's wait for this pipeline to be completed. Yeah, so let me go to the sync and let me execute this query. So you can see ID column is not present now and the country column is coming after age column. So this happened because we have changed the mapping in this mapping tab. Okay, so that's it for this video, guys. In this video, we learned how to make use of additional column in copy activity. So please stay tuned and please hit on like button and please subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it yet. Thank you.